lucky home. 'Tis summer, the fields are a-gray.
'Tis summer, the fields are
a-gray. Crops ripe and the meadows in the bloom, while the birds make music all the day.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, this is our prayer to you for the Knox Central graduates of 2013. Father, we ask of you in Jesus' name that you would lead, guide, and direct our footsteps. We also ask that you would keep your hand over each and every one of our lives. We ask you, Father God, not one of us would leave this earthly world without knowing you, sweet Jesus. We pray to you, God, that your will be done in our lives here on earth as it is in heaven. We ask, Heavenly Father, that you would bless us and expand our territory, and please be with us in all that we do as we go forward in life. More than anything, Lord, we ask that everyone comes to know you in your saving grace and allows your will to be done in their lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
If everyone could please be seated. I would like to welcome everyone to Knox Central High School today. What a special day for the class of 2013. Now, as you can see, it's standing room only. So as we go through, please be courteous to all of our graduates as they come across this stage. Mr. Jake Pope is taking pictures down here, and we will retire the colors at the end, so please be aware of that. But once again, I would like to thank everyone who is in attendance today on this very special day. Up on the stage, I have a few people that I would like to introduce. To my left is the interim superintendent, Ralph Hoskins. Next to him is assistant superintendent, Kim Merida. Then next to him is board chair, Carla Jordan. Next to her is Sam Watts. Then next is Dexter Smith and Merle Smith. Charles Merida could not be here today with us, but he sends his wishes. Also, Ms. Assistant Superintendent Marion Souders, and both of my assistant principals could not be here today, Mr. David Jackson and Ms. Lana Souders, but they send their wishes. On the back row, we have our in charge of graduation, Melody Middleton and Chris Hubbard, the board attorney, Ashley Smith. We have, from the Sons of the American Revolutionary, Charles Scott. We have our counselors, Nancy White and Tammy Baker. Next to them is Kentucky Tech Principal Ralph Halcomb. Next to him is the Knox Learning Academy Principal, Roger Vanover. Then next to him is the I-3 Achievement Counselor, Kathy Sue Smith, and our college coach, Courtney Miller. This is who's up on the board, or up on the stage. If you could give them a hand, please. The next thing I would like to do, because all of these people have been an integral part in raising these young men and women who are sitting in front of us today. So if I could have the parents of the graduates to please stand up at this time. And if you would stay standing, please. I'd like to have the grandparents that are in attendance to stand up, please. And because this does not only start in high school, anybody who has taught any of these young people that are in this auditorium here, anybody that's taught any of these young people, please stand also. Thank you, and you can be seated. The graduating class of 2013 is special to me because this is the first graduating class as me as the principal at Knox Central High School. This class has made great strides and had many accomplishments, but their biggest achievement is here today. I'd like to wish you all the very best. I'd like to hope that you come back and visit us. Let us see your smiling face as you go on through life and you're able to achieve everything that you're able to achieve. But as high school graduates today, just like I said every morning, I know that you're college and career ready, and you're going to continue to do great things for Knox County. Thank you, class of 2013. There are a couple of recognitions that I would like to do at this time. The first one that I would like to recognize, I would like Abigail Carnes to please stand up. Abigail is a young lady who has not missed a day of school for the last 13 years. That means she has perfect attendance since she has been in school. Thank you. The next group of students that I would like to recognize are our Governor's Scholars. If I could have Jenna Mills, John Tyler Smith, and Austin Sprinkle stand up, please. These students spent the summer at various colleges learning that college experience. So great job, young people. The next group we're going to recognize is by the Captain Charles Gatliff Chamber of the Kentucky Sons of the American Revolution, JROTC, American History Training Program, Certificate of Completion, which is awarded to the following students. So I need the following students to please come forward. Lieutenant Colonel Tony Gibbs, Major Weston Henson, Major Andrew Smith, Sergeant Jonathan Ty, Sergeant Miranda Allen, First Lieutenant Kara Bingham, Captain Michael Burke, Sergeant Brian Leith, Sergeant Elias Cruz, Captain Zachary Mitchell, Corporal Dwight Robinson, Captain Richie Shackelford, and First Sergeant Danielle Alexander. Right there. At this time, Mr. Charles Scott has a presentation for them.
Thank you, Mr. Milton. It's an honor for me to represent the Sons of the American Revolution at your graduation service. To be at a school that has patriotic leadership like Knox Central is refreshing for me. You are lucky. Not all schools are like this. I'm here today to help recognize some of the JROTC cadets who have completed the Advanced American History Revolutionary War course. With this additional level of learning about our early American history, I am confident that many of you know much more about General George Washington and America's First Army than when you begin your training. To my knowledge, your school is the only school in America that has a hallway dedicated to America's First Army. About 40 Revolutionary War era pictures grace this hallway, Revolution Hall. To become a member of the Sons of the American Revolution, I had to trace my ancestry back to show that I had a direct ancestor that either fought or provided assistance to the military during the Revolutionary War. By being a student of Knox Central High School, you have something very similar. Your school gets its name because it's located in Knox County, Kentucky. Your county was named after a Revolutionary War patriot, Henry Knox. When the American Revolutionary War broke out in 1775, Henry Knox quickly rose to become the chief artillery officer of the Continental Army. In this role, he accompanied General George Washington on most of his campaigns and had involvement in many actions of the war. Following the adoption of the United States Constitution, Henry Knox became President Washington's Secretary of War. Some cities and counties throughout the United States are named after Patriot Henry Knox, including this county and also Kentucky's military installation, Fort Knox, Kentucky. So as you graduate from Knox Central High School, remember proudly where you live and where you went to high school, because both were named after this great patriot. Congratulations on your graduation. The Sons of the American Revolution, in addition to presenting the certificates to you, each year we present a bronze JROTC medal to an outstanding cadet. The cadet must show a high degree of merit in leadership qualities, military bearing, and general excellence. This year, our medal goes to Cadet Major Weston Henson.
Thank you.
What a nice honor on our Memorial Day weekend. The last group that I would like to recognize is the top 10 of the class of 2013. If I could have the following students come up and join me on the stage: Holly Tidwell, Cassidy Shippey, JoBeth Bingham, Allison Swafford, Ashlyn Page Cobb, Haley Grubb, John Tyler Smith, Gil Jackson, Austin Sprinkles, and Jenna Mills. At this time, I would like to introduce the senior class president, John Tyler Smith.
Good afternoon. I would like to thank everyone who made it out here, all of the parents, the grandparents, everyone who supported these fine young men and women to getting to this point. I would like to... Can you hear me now? All right. Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to thank all the parents and the grandparents and everyone else who helped these young men and women get here today. I would like to thank all of the teachers, all the faculty, the principals, everyone who made it possible for us to be here. It made it possible for us to get through high school to our graduation. It's been hard at times. It's been really fun at times. Overall, it's just been great. Live long and prosper. We have a senior class video that's been prepared. I haven't seen it yet. I don't think many people here, many of the graduates have seen it yet, so expect a few tears. We got the video.
Thank you. hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want until your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. I hope you never look back, but you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want until your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. Yeah.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end, that's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Going through my closet the other day, I found an old yearbook, flipped right to the page of that senior trip down there on that Panama Strip. We all started yelling when we smelled the beach. Couldn't wait to try our fake IDs. We only had a few days and a whole lot of memories to make. Oh man, we were living, didn't waste 1 minute. We talked and drank and danced and said goodbye. We laughed until we cried.
this past year, my family was sitting cross-legged round the Christmas tree listening to Granddad. We all knew it'd probably be his last. He was cracking jokes and we were taking turns telling stories about fishing or lessons learned out on the porch with him. We all felt like kids again. Sitting there reminiscing, we sang and talked and traveled back in time. We laughed and chilled the time. It's like the best days under the sun. Every emotion rolled into one.
Joey's head. And this is where I grew up. I think the prison owner fixed it up. I never knew we ever went without. The second floor is hard for sneaking up. And this is where I went to school. Most of the time I'd better things to do. Criminal record says I'm broken twice. I must have done it half a dozen times. I wonder if too late. Should I go back and try to graduate? Life's better now than it was back then. If I was them, I wouldn't let me in. Oh, 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 oh God, I am. Every memory of looking out the back door. I have a photo I was spread out on my bedroom floor. It's hard to say it, down to say it.
Closing time, open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time, turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time, one last call for alcohol, so finish your whiskey or beer. Closing time, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. I know who would want to take me home. I know who would want to take me home. I know who would want to take me home. Take me home.
What a great 4 years. At this time, I'd like to bring up the salutatorian of the class of 2013, Mr. Austin Sprinkles.
History will be kind to me, for I intend to write it. Winston Churchill. Today, we, the Knox Central class of 2013, stand at the threshold of writing our own history. And today, I can promise you that I am confident that history will be just as kind to our class as it was to Winston Churchill, because the world is at our fingertips, and we will be the authors of our future. In my opinion, history is the most important subject you can learn for countless reasons. Many of us dread history class because we think it's boring or useless. Even I often cringed at the mention of the dreaded SQ3Rs from AP US History. Sorry, Miss Middleton, I still loved every second of our class. But I say it's wrong to avoid the lessons of history because history can be very fascinating and even more useful. Many people think history is nothing more than dates and facts, but it is actually much more than that. History is the foundation on which our future is shaped. Everyone in this room has some type of shared history with another person in this room through common experience. Class of 2013, as I am reading this speech, I want you to think of the history of our class and the memories we have made. Do not forget them, but build on them and draw from them as you embark on the future. Now I will share with you some lessons from history has taught me, and I hope you can take them with you as you write the pages of history. One of the biggest lessons I've learned from history is that success can come from the unlikeliest people. One of my favorite examples of this is Benjamin Franklin, one of my personal heroes. Franklin was the 15th son of a candle maker who fled from his family at the age of 18 to make a new start for himself in Philadelphia. At the time, Franklin was young, very intelligent, but also had a rebellious streak about him that reminds me very much of several of my classmates. Franklin went on to become America's greatest scientist and inventor and was a leading figure in the development of American independence. His contemporary, John Adams, was the son of a shoemaker who went on to become a great advocate for independence and later vice president and president of the United States. They and numerous others who worked to build this nation overcame many difficulties to make a land based on freedom, liberty, and equality. I believe that these men and women had a great drive for success that led them to do great things. Many believe that the historical impact of our founding generation is superior in significance to our own generation, but I strongly believe that the class of 2013 will have opportunities to impact the world that would rival the revolutionaries of 1776, and we can go on to accomplish great things if we put our minds, hearts, and bodies to the task. We can also learn from history. The other day, I heard a speech from class president John Herman Tyler Smith, who said that the main purpose of studying history is to gain information from our past to be able to make a better future, or to be able to make a better choice in the present to ensure a better future for our species. There are multiple lessons from which we can learn from history, whether they be successes or failures. Hitler should never have invaded Russia in the winter after Napoleon failed at the same task, and the class of 2013 should never have done three senior pranks after a certain gym floor incident during the class of 2011's prank. And by the way, Mr. Milton, I hope the salad dressing in the elevator didn't go bad. But in all seriousness, we, the class of 2013, should look at the mistakes of past leaders, parents, friends, and others, as well as our own personal mistakes, and build on those to become better citizens, friends, family members, workers, humanitarians, and overall better people. Finally, you can look at history to gain wisdom and knowledge. Life is an educational experience, and I plan on learning as much as I can until the day I die, and I hope you will as well. History is the supreme educator because of its all-encompassing definition. Everything we know comes from the past. As we go on to be CCR, which for those of you who don't know, is College and Career-ity, we should continue to look at the past to know what we need to do for the present to prepare us for the future. Those great historical figures such as Washington, Bolivar, Lincoln, and Churchill influenced many of us, but I'm sure we all have other influences. Many of us who are sitting here today, such as Coach Hillard, Kathy Sue, and many others, some who wholeheartedly wish that they could be here today, and others who have passed on, but would be so proud to see this moment. To me, all these people are important because they have had an influence on some young mind and have thus contributed to the future more than they can imagine. The class of 2013 should not influence the influences of those who mean so much to us. We should do good things to have an influence on the future generations so that we may carry out what generations before us have given us. That is what history is all about. Remember this, class of 2013. We have a shared history together, beginning from our first day of middle school until this present moment. We are making history today, and we will continue to make history tomorrow, whether by accomplishing great feats or even by the smallest influence we may have on others. I'm going to finish with a quote I found written by Miss Pope's famous red ink in my memory book, "Be the Change You Wish to See in the World," Gandhi. And also, I want to thank all those who have helped me get to this point in life, from my parents, grandparents, family, teachers, and most of all, God.
At this time, the class of 2013 valedictorian Jenna Mills, if she'll come forward, please.
Fellow graduates, faculty, administrators, friends, and family. Some people consider high school the best 4 years of their life, but honestly, these are just the best 4 years of our lives at the moment. As class historian, I've had the opportunity to reminisce on the past 4 years. But today, as class valedictorian, I think it is more important to focus on where we will be in the next 4 years. Whether it is teaching future generations, designing new video games, providing care for the sick, or inspiring people through the arts, we must all make sure we are aiming for success. My experience as a student athlete has taught me that life can be compared to sports. First, there are two types of people, players and spectators. In life, you cannot afford to be a bystander. Choose to be active. Don't just watch life, experience it. Start by setting goals, setting good examples, creating a positive image, and making your life the best it can be. Sometimes when the game gets difficult or your team is down, it's easier to make excuses on why you're not winning. Instead, in this game of life, keep fighting no matter the odds. Don't make excuses because of your gender, race, or socioeconomic background. Every one of us getting our diploma today can be successful and win at life. The second aspect of life that reminds me of sports is being part of a team. The team we are joining today is society. Be a contributing member of society. A team is only as good as its weakest member. We must have a strong work ethic and trust in ourselves that we can achieve anything. There are going to be times when you have to face many obstacles and life will seem too hard, but don't panic. Remember that life can get better when you have a positive attitude, an education, the right friends, and determination. And remember, we are leaving here today and going our separate ways, but we will always be on the same team, the KCHS Class of 2013. The last part of my sports analogy is that there are great leaders in sports as well as in life. Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, "Do not go where the path may lead, go instead where there is no path and leave a trail." Leave a trail that others would be glad to follow. It's up to all of you, class of 2013, to make a difference and have people say respectable things about you because you never gave up on yourselves. You can only achieve greatness through hard work. Go forward, work hard, and reach greatness. The kind of greatness that will make your dreams a reality. In closing, I would like to thank God for giving me the ability to be here today. I would like to thank the teachers and administrators for all of the time and dedication they have devoted to me and all of the other graduates. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for your love and support and for always pushing me. Congratulations and good luck, class of 2013.
Mr. Hoskins, Board of Education, at this time we'd like to present our diplomas to the class of 2013.
Stacia Abner with Greenleaf recipient Victoria Pope. Tiffany Alexander. Miranda Allen. Kimber Asher. Gretchen Baker. Jessica Bargo. Gabrielle Bargo. Glenna Bargo. Ashley Bays. Jacob Bays. Rebecca Bays. Dustin Bingham. James Bingham. JoBeth Bingham with Greenleaf recipient Gerald Wilder. Kara Bingham. Lauren Bingham. Matthew Bingham. Megan Bingham. Kayla Blakely. James Brewer. Nicole Brock. Bethany Brooks. Darius Broughton. Whitney Broughton. Brittany Brown. Brian Brown. Corey Bruner. Miranda Bundy. Michael Burke. Brady Burns, and his Greenleaf recipient was Mr. David Jackson, who is not in attendance with us today. Jeffrey Kennedy, Greenleaf recipient, Scott Russell. Abigail Carnes. Lauren Carnes. Joshua Castle. Valerie Chavies. Ashlyn Cobb with Greenleaf recipient Nancy Davis. Miranda Cornett. Gina Cox with Greenleaf recipient Donna Smith. Maxine Crawford. Cody Daniels. Austin Dillingham. Austin Doolin. James Dozier. Alyssa Dunn. Kayla Dye. William Ely. Jonathan Farthing. Joshua Fugate with Greenleaf recipient Keith Broughton. Oakley Gambrill. Cody Garland. Michaela Games. Kathy Garland. David Garrison. Megan George with Greenleaf recipient Virginia Rhodes. Morgan George, Greenleaf recipient Tonya Allen. Tony Gibbs. James Gibson. Jimmy Gibson. Emily Goins. Kara Goins. Brandon Gray. Destiny Gray with Greenleaf recipient Gina Martin. Mercedes Gray. Nicholas Gray. Roger Gray. Scotty Gray. Dustin Grubb. Haley Grubb with Greenleaf recipient Victoria Pope. Jeffrey Grubb. Kayla Hamilton. Vance Hammonds. Joshua Hampton. Brittany Hatfield. Cameron Hatfield. Austin Hensley. Bethany Hensley. Brent Hensley. Keith Hensley. Alicia Henson. Weston Henson. Ashley Hibbard. Ida Hobbs. Stephanie Hobbs. Austin Hodge with Greenleaf recipient Lisa Harris. Brianna Honeycutt. Amber Howard with Greenleaf recipient Lori Smith. Alvin Hubbard. Cody Hubbard. Cody Hubbard. Kendra Hubbard. Michaela Hubbard. Terry Hubbard. Brandy Huff. Woo! Guillermo Jackson, with Greenleaf recipient Daryl Dixon. Elizabeth Johnson, with Greenleaf recipient Eddie Campbell. Brandon Jones. Megan Jones.
Marina King. Haley Knuckles. Cheyenne Lambert. Joshua Lawson. Brian Leith. Brianna Ledford. Joshua Ledford. Bradley Lewis. William Logan. Amanda Lovett. At this time, the family of Brian Marion will be receiving an honorary diploma in his memory. Morgan McNett. Find out for me. John Mays. Ted Merida. Kyle Merida. Miranda Messer. Travis Messer. Amelia Miller. Megan Miller. Michaela Miller. Alicia Mills. Bethany Mills. Katrina Mills. Jenna Mills, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Leanne Mills. Marcus Mills. Travis Mills. Joshua Miracle. Casey Mitchell, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Crystal Miller. Zachary Mitchell. Mike Moore. Gregory Napier. Jeffrey Newton. Connie Owens. Emily Parton, accompanied by Eddie Campbell, standing in for Greenleaf recipient Lois Volpenhain. Jared Parton. Jason Payne. Dustin Phipps. Sierra Porter. Ashley Price. Timothy Puckett. Amber Rice, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Tonya Allen. Christopher Rice. Tabitha Riley. Tyler Riley. Dwight Robinson. John Robinson. Adam Russell. Ashley Sammons. Richie Shackelford. Matthew Shelton. John Shepherd. Jonathan Shepherd. Cassidy Shippey, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Brandon Hillard. Kristen Sizemore. Samantha Skaggs. Amy Smith. Andrew Smith. Derek Smith. John Tyler Smith, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Charlotte McCoy. Joshua Smith. Marissa Smith. Timothy Smith. Tressa Smith. Lauren Souders. Christina Sparks. Austin Sprinkles, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Helen Moore. Swafford, accompanied by Greenleaf recipients Rodney and Melissa Swafford. Ashley Teague. Tori Terrell. Holly Tidwell, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Victoria Pope. Jonathan Vaughn. Whoops. James Tomlinson. Jonathan Ty. William Tyree. Cassandra Vaughn. Nathaniel Vaughn. Jeremy Wagers. William Walters. Armani Wardlaw. Lindsay West. Jacob Wilburn. Allison Wilder. Destin Williams. Sherry Williams. Amber Wilson, accompanied by Greenleaf recipient Molly Shields. Joshua Wilson. Jesse Witt. Nathan Bryant. Devin Evans. Tiffany Smith. Elias Cruz. Jackie Ramey. Jesse Vaughn. Adam Rose. Austin Black. Russell Sinners. Joshua Lowe. Alan Sturdivant. Christy Mays. And Tiffany Hoskins.
All right, can you guys hear me? Are we good? All right. All right, Simon says, gentlemen, please remove your caps. Okay, ladies, you can be seated. Just kidding, Simon didn't say that. Okay. Before I pray, I'd like to thank the people in my life that have helped me, that have helped mold me into the young man I am today. Mom, Dad, Nanny, my brother, my aunt and uncle, and the rest of my family. My closest friends, Tyler, Josh, TJ, Travis, and Kyle. My church family and my two favorite educators, Keith Broughton and Molly Shields. Most of all, God. Without him, I would not have been blessed with these amazing people in my life. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for allowing us to gather here today on this beautiful day which you've blessed us with. We are thankful for the opportunity to have you openly a part of the ceremony. Lord, for over the past decade, you have used the school system to bless us all tremendously with once-in-a-lifetime friendships, incredible teachers, and sometimes two-in-one, to create countless unforgettable memories and mold our minds and our hearts so that we are ready to embark on the journey that is tomorrow. For that, we thank you. Today, so bittersweet, is a closing paragraph to a large chapter of our lives. For soon after today, many of us will leave the sheltered lives of our homes where we receive daily guidance from our parents and loved ones. But we are not alone. I pray, Lord, that you be with us each and every day and guide us wherever we may go, watching over us and protecting us from evil. That the decisions we made are made through you. That you give us the patience of Job when tested, the courage of David when trialed, the obedience of Noah when guided, and the love of Christ always and forever. No matter the path we choose to walk, I pray we all walk it with you, Lord. In your loving name I pray. Amen.
At this time, we're going to retire the colors, and then I present to you the class of 2013, Mr. Hoskins. Thank you.
On behalf of the Knox County Board of Education, it's an honor to accept this class of 2013. Congratulations.